Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy, with another in the series on the Edison 1878 demonstration tinfoil phonograph. Now, I just got some new 1-inch copper foil. This is almost identical to that snail tape, but it isn't snail tape. It's slightly thicker, and I got a sample, so I only have about, I think it's 42 inches of it. And I'm just going to give it a try to see what it sounds like. Unfortunately, it's only 1 inch wide, so it's going to be difficult to make a decent recording with it. But I'm going to try anyway, just to try the foil. And in the next video, I'm going to actually record on tin foil. I got a very small supply of original tin foil, and I'm going to be trying that. But this just came. This is Saturday, and this stuff just got here, so I wanted to do a quick test. Now, this is tape, and this is for shielding on guitar bodies, just like the other stuff has been, electronic shielding. And you line the wooden body, the cutouts where the pickups go in a guitar, or wooden guitar, electric guitar, and then you line it with this, and then solder onto it, and this acts as a shield. But I've been experimenting with all kinds of copper, and copper gives pretty good results. The problem with it is, first of all, it's expensive. The second is trying to find copper tape 2 inches wide. I found it, but it's not very prevalent. So now it's just a matter of getting this tape on here in a straight line. See, the problem with this is it's 18 inches long. And you line it up on the mandrel, and if you're off just a slightest bit on this end, by the time you get to the other end, you're off a quarter of an inch. And I can see I'm already way off. So I've got to line it up on a straight line and see if I can't lay this on there reasonably straight. All right, let's try this and see what happens. I think it's way off, but it's probably good enough for doing this test. I guess we're going to find out. So, just sticking this stuff onto the mandrel as I'm turning it and going around. Alright, we're definitely off, but not that bad. One groove, maybe? So we have some copper on the mandrel, and I'll just do a quick recording of Mary Had a Little Lamb without the hello, 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 and the ha, 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 and see what happens. Alright, let's see where my first groove is. If we're into the foil, we're just now getting into it. So I guess I'll start here. Alright, definitely in the groove now. Alright, so a quick test of Mary Had a Little Lamb. No idea how this is going to work. This is slightly thicker. It's a half a thousandth thicker than the actual copper snail tape. So let's see how this goes. Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. All right, plenty of room. So we'll rewind the mandrel. I have no idea what this is going to sound like. But every time I find a new source for tape or new thickness, I try it, regardless of its width, just so I can see what kind of recording it makes. Okay, so here's a recording on the new copper 1-inch tape. Alright, well, a bit noisier than the snail tape and the other copper tape, but a fairly clear recording. Let's play it again. All right, so not a terrible recording. So, like I said, I've been experimenting with every kind of sticky-backed aluminum copper tape I can find. Hopefully, eventually, I'll find something that's 2 1/4 inches wide that lays on there perfectly that makes a great recording. Haven't found it yet. I found a lot of copper tape that makes decent recordings, but it's really expensive. Some copper tapes that make terrible recording, some aluminum foil that makes pretty good recordings, and lots of foil that makes really, really bad recordings. So, like I said, every time I come across a new tape, I try it just to find out. Anyway, I bought a 42-inch sample of this stuff, and it just got here, so I thought I'd just do a quick recording to see how it worked. And it works, but it's not spectacular, but better than some of the foils that I've tried, for sure. So this is 1-inch copper. This is 1.5 thousandths of an inch thick, so it's slightly thicker than snail tape. Probably basically the same thing. So I'll continue my experiments, trying every kind of foil I possibly can. But in the meantime, like I said, whenever I run across a new foil, I want to do a video just to document the experiment. So recording on 1-inch copper tape that's 1.5 thousandths of an inch thick. So, as I said, not stellar performance, but a decent recording considering this is a 1878 tinfoil phonograph. So just wanted to do a quick video. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.